And one thing I'm still very much into to do with football is the culture of football songs. Because I love football songs, because football songs, they're always written by the common people and not censored in any shape or form. And that means football songs, they usually tell you a lot about what's right and wrong in a society. And if you were to ask me, Henning, is there one football song that sums up everything that's wrong with Scotland? Yes, there is one football song that sums up everything that's wrong with Scotland. You know that song, it's about 30 years old, but today is still every little bit as relevant as it was back then. You know that song. Could you go a chicken supper, Bobby Sands? Could you go a chicken supper, Bobby Sands? Could you go a chicken supper, dirty Fenian fucker? Could you go a chicken supper, Bobby Sands? And that song sums up everything that's wrong with Scotland. Quality of food. Now, Bobby Sands, depending on your viewpoint, was an Irish freedom fighter or IRA terrorist. I haven't got an opinion one way or the other, and if I had one, I would keep it firmly to myself. I mean, there's two things that are undisputed about Bobby Sands across the sectarian divide, and that is that he was Catholic and on a hunger strike. By being on that hunger strike, he had the moral high ground, and the Protestants obviously didn't like that. Protestants, they wanted to tempt him away from the hunger strike. So what the Protestants did, they met in one of their orange lodges. White gloves to here, bowler hat, flute, dole money. One of them holding a pen, the one that could write, was nicknamed the professor. Saying that Bobby Sands, he's on a hunger strike, we're not liking that, we want to tempt him away from there. Is there any dish that no right-minded person could possibly refuse? And the best they could come up with was a chicken supper. A fried chicken with chips. Second verse, could you go a can of Coke to wash it down? So essentially they were thinking, we're giving that Bobby Sands, we're offering him fried chicken, chips and a can of Coke. And at the strength of that delicacy, yeah, he'll immediately abandon his hunger strike and tuck in. I mean, for how unsophisticated did they take that Bobby Sands? You know, if fried chicken, chips and a can of Coke really was a delicacy, how shit must the prison food have been? Probably, I think Bobby Sands probably did not have a political agenda. No, he didn't. Bobby Sands did not have a political agenda. He just wanted a nice salad. A tomato, cucumber, feta, cheese, olives, onions, fresh basil on top. Obviously, British government couldn't give in to such a demand. No, because we're talking Belfast, late 70s, early 80s. Where were they going to get any fresh basil from? A Semtex, yes, by the carload. Fresh basil, Ulster says no. I mean, the French, they give up a lot. Most frequently Paris. No? Yeah, but no French person would ever abandon their hunger strike at the prospect of fried chicken, chips and a can of Coke. If anything, they would start a hunger strike. Yeah, but still, it is. Working here as a comedian is brilliant. The one downside to it is indeed the quality of food. I mean, if you're here in Edinburgh, it's fantastic. Down in London, fantastic. But out in the sticks, more often than not, plain horrendous. I mean, we all have got an idea about what restaurants should be like, don't we? We have got idea like the restaurant shouldn't have more than, let's say, 6 tables, and there is a quite rotund owner, the rotund owner in the morning. He's got a genteel stroll to the market, has got a right old chinwag with his favorite suppliers, only buys the freshest ingredients, and then prepares them in his own special manner, and adds a few herbs from his own garden, and potters away whilst humming away to classical music. That's the theory. The reality is Pizza Express. Yeah, where someone has got no interest whatsoever in working in a kitchen is given the chance to throw large quantities of salt onto some already processed shit, and then someone else that has got equally no interest of working in a restaurant brings it to your table, giving you briefly the impression that you're in a restaurant. I mean, it's everything about Pizza Express is wrong. I mean, if I've got Italian food, I don't want the proceeds to benefit some global conglomerate. If I've got Italian food, I want to eat it in a safe knowledge that it will benefit the local mafia. And therefore, I much prefer Kentucky Fried Chicken. No, because they're a lot more honest in their approach and how they rate you as a customer. Because they serve their food in a bucket. Say, yeah, you're an animal. Here, have a bucket of shit. Off you go. Bye. The quality of food is still horrendous. Just the other day, a former England player thought he could stop a murderer on the run by offering some fried chicken. And a dressing gown and fishing rod and can of lager, some bread. Moody, it's Gaza. True story. No, it's absurd and interesting. Someone would give up their hunger strike with prospect of fried chicken, chips and a can of Coke. It's absurd. It's a bit like someone going, ooh, I'll abstain from sex from now on. I'll never ever have sex again. And then the maid goes, don't speak too early. Look over there, Camilla Parker bowls.